U.S. state and local governments often rely on bonds to finance construction and improvements of roads, schools, and other capital projects. Municipal bonds are frequently described as tax-exempt because the interest income they generate is not subject to federal income taxes. For example, consider a taxpayer earning $1 million annually. They would fall in the 37% marginal income tax bracket. If that taxpayer holds a taxable bond bearing $100 in interest annually, the federal government collects $37 in taxes on the bond's $100 in annual interest. The after-tax income from the taxable bond is $63. If the same taxpayer bought an identical tax-exempt bond sold by a state or local government, they would receive $100 in tax-free interest income. Municipal bonds are particularly popular with high-income taxpayers seeking to shield investment income from taxes. Bond investors compete with one another to acquire bonds that offer the greatest after-tax return. These investors are willing to accept smaller pre-taxed interest payments on municipal bonds because of the tax exemption. For example, suppose a standard taxable corporate bond carries a 10% interest rate. Investors in the top marginal tax bracket would eagerly purchase an identical tax-exempt municipal bond with an interest rate of at least 6.3%. This reflects the fact that the return on the corporate bond is effectively 6.3% after taxes. As such, the difference between the interest rate of a taxable bond and a tax-exempt bond closely reflects the top federal marginal income tax rate, currently 37%. The tax exemption enables state and local governments to borrow at a lower interest rate than other entities. The federal government effectively subsidizes the borrowing costs of state and local governments, allowing them to finance important capital projects at a lower cost to their residents. This arrangement is also advantageous to high-income individuals who shield a portion of their income from taxes. The U.S. Treasury estimates this tax preference cost the federal government $31 billion in 2017. The nonpartisan Tax Policy Center think tank determined the majority of these tax savings accrued to the top 5% of the income distribution.